sponsored by PCBWay.
Project in a day challenge, let's go!
There we go, nice and festive.
So what is time? How do we know what minutes are? When it comes to units of measurement, we have an intuition developed over time. For example, I have a much better intuition for what 22 degrees Celsius will feel like in the air than I would for water temperature, for example, because I'm using that way less frequently. I can only imagine what's going on through my toddler's mind when I tell him in 5 minutes we're going to bed. So I'm making a visual countdown timer for me to point at and support my argument there. I said one day, but let's make it 8 hours total because it might involve some overnight 3D printing. Let's start the clock. If I only had a visual timer for this video. The concept is to have a sort of a progress bar in reverse, and I want to design it around a 30 LEDs per meter strip, which is the sparsest you can get off the shelf. 6 LEDs should give enough range while also not exceeding the build volume of my Prusa Mark III. Each LED will light its own cell and they will gradually go out as time passes. I also need a screen and a rotary encoder for the parent to set it up. The smooth operator in this sleepy time deal. Keeping it as simple as possible, you turn the knob, set the time and start the countdown. The kid will eventually play with the knob, so being childproof is a strict requirement. Electronics, let's see. The LED strip, of course. A microcontroller, of course. The D1 Mini, my favorite. A small OLED screen. A rotary encoder, cheap and highly available. I need the OLED to run on I2C to not run out of good pins on my D1 Mini. For a second there, I thought the screen might be the same width as an LED cell, but it's slightly bigger. I'll work that out later. Anyway, let's move into CAD and see how it goes. First things first, modeling the LED strip. What do you know, each LED is 50mm by 50mm, it's not called a 50-50 package for nothing. Let's multiply that across, size up the strip, extrude away. Okay, that was brain dead simple, but for other components I don't want to model from scratch. I also don't want to do the wiring up, but this time I actually have a way around it. Lovely people on the internet already applied the elbow grease and were kind enough to share their work with everybody. I already had a model for the rotary encoder, but I never used this small screen before, so heading over to GrabCAD, the best resource for open source step models. And it's as easy as that. Now this is something I should have done from the start instead of hard coding that value here. What I actually want to do is to define a user parameter with the value. This way I can easily reuse without having to remember it, and I can also easily change it without having to track down all the instances where I used it. Great, this should be enough to sketch the back profile and move on from there. I'm using symmetry to my advantage, I'm only sketching a corner. Then mirroring 2 times to get a full cell, then rectangular pattern that across, using my newly defined user parameter, of course. I can now extrude the back panel, also add the 3-perimeter outer wall. Time to add the rest of the components and place them as precise as possible without spending too much time on it. I'm already at the 1 hour mark. Screws. I need some thread forming screws to attach the back and the front covers, so I'm rummaging through my box of recovered screws. Whenever I find screws for plastic, I collect them as they are very handy for 3D printed parts. I'm sizing the hole to be 0.2mm smaller in diameter than the outer diameter of the thread, which is more than enough when you factor in the printer and filament tolerances. Making a hole for the screen. Making a hole for the USB port. And because I'm already well past the 2 hour mark, let's try some idea to create a light diffuser by adding a single bridged over layer near the front of the cells such that they would break the direct light from... The LEDs are far from powerful enough for such shenanigans, so never mind. Let's start the print of the back panel instead. And go get another coffee while we talk about the sponsor of this video. PCBWay, because they make way better prints than me. And not only filaments, you can SLS,
powder fused with lasers,
in nylon or TPU, SLM,
same but for metals,
or maybe SLA,
UV resin,
in transparent resin. Very cool stuff, go on PCBWay.com and browse through the options like a Christmas catalog. It's therapeutic. Oh, the clock's ticking. I need to tweak the modules to fit, a little amputation for the screen, and a complete extraction for the encoder.
Just a quick tip, I'm snipping the plastic in between the pins because it's much easier to desolder them one at a time. Where's the dreaded activity? Oh great, the back panel finished printing. Let's check it out. Should have compensated more for the sagging on the bridging, but it will do. I also horizontally cut a piece of the body and printed it to test that everything fits before printing the whole thing. This is always a good idea. Of course, it proved useful this time too. I discovered my OLED is slightly offset. And also I didn't clear a route for the wires. Anyway, back to the brilliant task of wiring, but I won't make you watch this. To me, this looks eager to receive a firmware. The logic. We start in an off state, long press and we get to the pause state. This is where we set the time using the encoder and the screen. Then we double click because we want it to be childproof to get to the countdown state where the timer is running and the time is not editable anymore. And most importantly, the LED cells display the progress, or should I say the regress. Pretty simple, let's turn this into Arduino code. What I actually did was to run I2C scanner sketch to check my screen connection, use the graphics library to show a value on the screen, set up the rotary encoder with interrupts, coded the logic of the three states in the loop, ran into various edge cases when displaying the time, and of course, bugs. First working prototype. Still need to hook up the LED strip, but first let's make the graphics pretty. For that I'm browsing through the UAG2 font, first the icons. I need an icon for the editable state and one for the countdown state. That one to me looks like a hand turning a knob. And now I want an hourglass. This feels like looking for items in the fridge, most likely a bug in the membrane. There it is. Let's count it down in hex. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D. Now the font for the digits, I want a less plain one, that's big enough. Maniac, perfect match. Here's what it looks like, it's blinking when editable. Here's the cute hourglass. And this is the off state. It's time to start printing the body and take a break for the day. Hooking up the LED strip. The direction is very important on the data pin, by the way. Well, guess what else gonna need to reprint? The face panel, it's much too opaque. Let's take away all the failed prints and guide the components in. The encoder is the bulkiest, so it's best to come in from the front. Now it's a good time to bolt the encoder to the face panel, and with this the face part is pretty much done. The screen goes in next and I'm just slightly jamming it in there, it's designed to be held in place by plane friction. I couldn't find an easy way to securely mount the microcontroller in place, it's also the one that actually needs to be solid because we'll push a power cable in it. So I decided to stick it down with epoxy putty. It hardens quickly, it's strong and you don't have to design too much for it. On the flip side, it's permanent, kind of messy, and it can be brittle if it ends up with thin areas. Oh, did I mention messy? Well, at least it comes out okay-ish with WD-40, which also cleans very well the tackiness left behind by tape or stickers, not a widely known trick I noticed. Final thing, screw in the back. And the front, and just a few minutes over time, we're done. Oh wait, I completely forgot about the knob. I could use a I'm not gonna use a stock one, I love designing knobs. So I'm gonna do it in overtime, it doesn't count. I tested it with the kiddo and it works great, by the way.
I want to refine this a bit, and if there's enough interest, I will probably make another video where you can follow along and build your own. So let me know in the comments. I'm gonna make the files available for this one too. But stay tuned and maybe subscribe, I don't know. Catch you in the next one. Catch you in the next one.